Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
In our industry, there are a lot of camps, right? So if those camps exist, they're given more importance, and that's why people, when they come to go to those camps, they get work or they don't get work. Then they say, okay, they started choosing only this category of people and not that category of people. My father ran away from the village to become an actor. He was a nobody. So now somebody like a nobody becomes an actor. So he gives me this life, but he didn't make me an actor who survived 25 years. Right? That was on my work that spoke for me. And I did go through 3-4 years of no work, but that was my own doing. Because I went off track.
Bobby, welcome back to Film Companion.
Thank you so much for having me.
First of all, congratulations on 25 years in the movie business. That's a big milestone.
Yes, and I didn't realize that. But thank you so much.
You know, it's interesting to me that in the 25th year, you have a film like Class of 83, you know, in which we see you in a sort of a role that we haven't often seen you in, this sort of hardened, honest cop. Tell me, I felt like you were really having a good time playing him. Did you enjoy being Dean Vijay Singh?
Yes, I did. I definitely did, because I was always, you know, trying to look for characters to play as the one I played in this film. And it is not so difficult. It's not very easy to come across these kind of characters. So, because once you have, you know how it is, once a character has an image, it's not easy for them to try. Even if they try, they don't get a chance and opportunity to get these kind of roles, you know, because they're always given to these serious actors who usually always end up getting these kind of roles. So for me, because the way my career has moved and from a bad phase to again a decent phase now in my life, which is a great phase for me, things are looking nice. And then I was always looking forward to working on OTT platform, and because I've been watching a lot of stuff on Netflix and the other OTT platforms, and they all have very interesting stuff. You know, you come across movies which are so simple, and they have a simple narrative, and you just sit there and you watch them and you enjoy them, you know, because you get engrossed with the storytelling and the simplicity of the way they move with the characters and things like that. And then you get to see the other side of other kinds of genres which are quite different but yet interesting to watch. So when Red Chillies, Shah Rukh's production house, approached me with Netflix, I was really excited, because for someone like me who's been through a phase, to get a production house and with Netflix joining hands, it was a very exciting moment. But the only thing was that I was still fearing as to how the subject is going to be, you know, because at the end of the day, I'm trying to move forward. And for me to move forward, it'll only be possible if I choose the right kind of characters and the right kinds of scripts. Because end result, no one knows how people react to the end product. But at least as an actor, it gives you an opportunity to display your talent in whichever way you can. And the day I heard the idea and I read the script, I was so happy that I'm getting a script like this. I'm really getting a script like this. So I really, you know, I did workshops with my co-actors, and I really enjoyed this new way of approach to cinema. Before, when we started our careers, I remember sitting with Vinod in the evenings before every day, next day, and doing the scenes, you know. I mean, that was my first feel of workshop, but in a very sweet way. And it never happened after that, you know, for many years. And I think that really helped me when I was doing Curry, you know. So this time, I make a point that people do workshops and go through lines with each other, so that first of all you break the ice and then you understand each other's reactions and, you know, everything. So we did that, and I was sitting with these five guys, young talented boys from theater, and I was nervous like hell. I was like,
really?
They were so well prepared.
You were the veteran actor on this set. Well, you didn't give out advice. They made you nervous?
They made me nervous in the sense that they were so well prepared, and they had such a grip on their diction and everything, you know. It's just amazing how good they were. And I was so happy working with them, because for me, see, I mean, it's so easy to be there in the industry for so many years, but you're always learning from others, you know. Mm. And for me, I was actually learning things from them as to how they approach, their approach towards how they do things, and then trying to understand that. But at the same time, one day we got to know each other, so I said, you know, I was really nervous with aapke saath hi baitha hu. Sir, aap nervous the, hum bhi aapke samne nervous the. I said, acha, chalo acha, ye nervous energy kaam aaye kyunki sabne acche acha kaam karne ki koshish ki. So for me, this character was so interesting, and I really enjoyed it because I could understand the emotions of him as a family man, understand his emotion as someone who wants to do the right thing, you know. And so somewhere, though I was out of my comfort zone, at the same time, the emotions were so real that it just came out naturally, I think.
But and Bobby, did you ever like ask, but did you ask Atul Sabharwal, the director, how he, you know, chose you? Because it's very counterintuitive casting, you know. Who would think of you in this role?
Well, you know, when I asked this question to even Gaurav, the producer, and even Atul, the question they gave me, the answer they gave me was, they were not sure if I would want to do something like this. You know, because what happens is people start to perceive, whatever that word is, they start to imagine that Bobby Deol only does these kind of roles. He would not want to go out of his comfort zone, things like that. And to break that is so difficult, but somehow it's happened for me this time. And I mean, I, as an actor, always give myself completely to my director. I mean, you've seen that when I was working with Vinod also. So I believe in that a lot because I know what the director is visualizing and what he's wanting from his actors. So it didn't take much for me and Atul to tune in with each other. And it was just smooth journey onwards after that, you know. It was just fun working on this film.
Tell me, Bobby, this idea of sort of the vigilante cop, you know, the cop who kind of breaks the law to, in a sense, uphold order, is one that we've seen in many films. But I think, you know, with the kind of increasing occurrences of police brutality in real life, do you have any concerns about what this film says? Or do you see this theme as problematic in any way?
See, when I started filming this film, I finished shooting for this film last year. And in our society, every day some new occurrence happens.
Yeah.
It could be from anywhere, you know, anything. So you can't choose your work according to that because you never know. One day one thing is good becomes bad. You know, you're just choosing projects because as an actor, it's inspiring you to do that, you know. So I don't know how it will affect in that negative way or positive way, but I just think that once people see the film, I think this film only shows positiveness of everything, you know. It does not, it's not trying to show you the brutality or what the police is or not. It is telling you that not every policeman is bad, you know. Not everybody from a different profession is bad or good. Everybody is different, you know. So if one bad person can make the whole community look bad, then it's not fair to the people who are good, you know, because they also don't live a very lavish lifestyle. They have simple lives. They are working hard, you know. They have small families, but to maintain a family is difficult. So all those things are kind of shown in these, in this film, and it's just trying to portray how in the real sense a cop is and what the system is and what he has to do to fight against the system, because everybody has to fight some system or the other, you know.
Yeah.
get them heard.
So Bobby, I don't think any interview these days is complete without you know, sort of conversation about a word that the last time we met you said that you didn't fully understand, which is of course nepotism. I remember about 2 years ago when you and I did an interview, you said, you know, when I first started, I didn't even understand ye hai kya, kiski baat kar rahe. So Bobby, do you have a larger sense of it now? And I don't know, do you worry about your sons? I know that you said that you don't know if they want to even be in the movies. But given what has played out in the last few months, what is your sense of what's going on? And are you concerned for your own kids?
I'm not concerned for the simple fact that when someone chooses a profession, no matter how much help you get or don't get, it's your talent that speaks for you, end of the day. You know, And there are a lot of people who want to be in this profession. And there's a lot of struggle. I mean, me being in the industry, I also have to struggle. So when it comes to struggling, they kind of find an easy way out or an easy excuse by saying, I can't even pronounce the word, but that is the reason why they're not getting work. But that is not the real answer, because if you see any professional side of any business, a father, first of all, when you have kids, why do you have kids? Why? Because you can afford to have kids. You can raise them the right way. You can see to it that they have proper education. And then finally, when it time comes for them to start their own life, they'll be capable enough to start it. And a parent will always see to it that he can do whatever he can to help his son or his daughter. What is wrong in that? That is a normal thing a child and a parent has as a relationship. So because a lot of people find it difficult, because in our industry, there are a lot of camps, right? So if those camps exist, they're given more importance, and that's why people, when they come to go to those camps, they get work or they don't get work. Then they say, okay, they started choosing only this category of people and not that category of people. I'm also being linked to nepotism, but where? I also have to struggle. I also have to go and knock on everybody's doors for work, you know? It has never been easy for me. So I think it's a misconception to a certain level. And at a certain level, it could be right. But I think that the more you make it sound right is the more you're giving up on yourself. I think you have the right in your hands to never give up. Be persistent. Believe in yourself. And not everybody's lucky. Not everybody becomes a superstar, you know? If that was the case, then only star kids would be superstars, right?
Yeah.
It's always the work that speaks for you. Eventually, you have to work hard and do your best as an actor. And that's what I think all the kids who are coming up should realize that. My father ran away from the village to become an actor. He was a nobody. So now somebody like a nobody becomes an actor. So he gives me this life, but he didn't make me an actor who survived 25 years, right? That was on my work that spoke for me. And I did go through 3-4 years of no work, but that was my own doing because I went off track. But if I wouldn't have gone off track those days, I'm sure people would have still given me and believed me and given me work. So I think I've proved that I'm back in that sense, that to let people know that I'm back as an honest person who wants to work as an actor. And that's the only goal I have in my life. I think in a way I'm more ambitious now than I've ever been
about really
doing the right kind of work. Yeah, because I think, I don't know, I have this extra energy in me and I just want to do the right kind of work. And I think Class of 83 has given me the opportunity to do that kind of character where people will notice me and understand me as an actor more than anything else, you know. And also there's so much young talent in it, which is given a chance on OTT platform, like all these 4-5 boys. I mean, they got work. I think OTT platform is great for people who are new talent, because there's so much new talent. There's so much good work. There's so much new talented kids on the block, you know. So
yeah.
OTT has done a good thing by coming into our lives. And I'm really excited and hoping that, you know, then people ask me, so why should we see this film? I said, see it for one of these boys, because one day one of them will become a big star. Why lose the opportunity of seeing that moment in their lives when they're starting off? Because no one knows who's going to reach where in their lives.
Yeah. So, but tell me, Bobby, is it freeing for you as an actor to not be working with those kind of constraints that you would have been if you were that straight up leading man? You know, now you can experiment, you can do whatever you want to. You can be the villain, you can be the hero, you can be this angry cop in Class of 83. Is that liberating?
It is really. You don't understand. It's like, I feel so excited with this new chapter in my life, because I am doing stuff which I never imagined I would even be asked to do. I'm excited about all the projects I'm going to be doing in the future. And it's not that I will only stick to just playing these kind of characters. I would do something commercial, even on OTT platform. I would still look at something which is a thriller, because I've grown up loving thrillers. I've grown up loving comedies. So definitely I would not just want to get stuck with just this, but this along with everything else, you know. So I just hope I'm lucky enough to get the variety in my life now.
Okay, last question, Bobby. You know, I read an interview in which you talked about how you said that you have to get lucky, but you can't rely on luck. You said that I am sort of going out of my way to learn whatever I can to be a better actor. So I was curious, you know, after 25 years of being in the business, what do you feel the need to learn now? What are you really hungry to learn?
See, I think maybe I've understood myself more now. You know, maybe you understand and you become more comfortable with yourself. You know, you never realize that do you need to be comfortable with yourself. And once you start understanding yourself, you get more comfortable with yourself, you start believing in yourself more. And then you want to improve yourself more. So you want to learn more. You want to make yourself even a better thing, a better person, a better actor, you know. So this is what I realized now at this juncture in my life, that I just need to improve as much as I can myself as an actor, till wherever my limit is. I want to break that limit. If I can, that will be the most amazing thing for me. And that's how I look at things now.
Nice. Which is wonderful. Bobby, thank you so much, and all best for Class of 83.
Thank you so much. You take care.
You
nice
too.
Talking to you always.
You too. Always, Bobby. Take care. Bye.
Take care. Bye.